Hello everyone, SP Architects here. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a real 3D roof in ARCHICAD. When we are making roofs in ARCHICAD, they seem very flat. Therefore, when rendering them, we won't receive any good quality results. In this reason, you may want to create real 3D roofs in your projects. Alright, let's get into the tutorial. Here we are in ARCHICAD. And this is our project. Maybe you know this project from my previous renderings or tutorials. We are going to modify this. We are going to add a roof and convert it to real 3D roof. Let's start this one by deleting this parapet first. When deleting something, you should pay attention to whether there is a group or not. By the way, if we get closer this parapet, you can see this is a composite style, and if you just right click and click edit, you can see its details. And when using something like this, you can just use this one as a simple wall, but in sections you don't need any detailed redrawing for your projects. Alright, we get rid of the parapets, but at this stage we have two options. For the roof design, of course, we can just extend this slab and put our roof onto it. You can just use offset icon here. By the way, this project working with millimeter. Let's change it to centimeter from length unit. Let's click this centimeter. Click OK. We are gonna click this corner and offset like so. Maybe 60 centimeters. There you go. But I'm gonna do this without slab eaves. To make a simple roof, we can just get rid of the unnecessary borders. For example, this corner, you can connect the edges and disappear one of them. The sunbreaker here is stuck inside the wall. It needs to be fixed. I'm gonna select these beams and intersect them with intersect command. I'll just shrink these extra parts here. To do that, we are going to click the corner and click stretch length. Also for these two additional beams, you can just select both and reduce its size one of them. After that, both of them will be reduced. Alright, now we can begin to create our roof. We are going to use magic wand tool. You just hit the spacebar and click the slab. Once we created the roof, we are going to change its slope from here. I'm gonna turn this into percent. I'm not working with degrees. Maybe 40% is going to be fine. There we go. We can go with this. As you can see, this is a composite roof style. We are not going to use this. We are just going to use this roof as a reference base. Therefore, I'm gonna change this thickness to 3 centimeters. You can think this is an isolation layer. We need to adjust the height of the roof from the ground. For this, we are going to take help from section or elevation. Let's go to floor plan and go to section tool. I'm gonna create a section in order to get a better view. Let's open our section and look at what we have. As you can see here, they were intersected together. Let's change this height, place this corner, and they won't be intersected anymore in 3D. Also, the roof and this sunbreaker is intersected. Let's fix them. The easiest way for doing this by grouping this sunshade and move them together. We hit to F5 to isolate them and get rid of unnecessary beams, select and group. Now we can use group selection, and from this angle we can change its height like so. There you go. Maybe more. Okay. Let's continue. Maybe we can change the slope angle for a get better view. 45 degrees do the trick. Maybe we can reduce the size of the offset to 60, I think. There you go. I'm now happy with the roof style. And now we can convert this to 3D roof. At the very first, we need to split this roof into single plane roofs. Click split anyway. And now we can select the roof parts one by one. We are going to go to floor plan. Go to roof. Let's go to design menu. But maybe before that, we can group the all of the roofs together. It may be helpful in the future. After that, we go to design and go to design extras, accessories, and roof accessories. In the opening window, we are going to use an object here, but for now, we cannot see it because we need a library. So let's go to file, go to library and objects, library manager. Once we open this, we will see this ad. Click that and locate your accessories library. It's under the ArchiCAD 24 library folder. ArchiCAD 24 folder is also available in other ArchiCAD versions. Let's click open and click OK. It's loading, by the way. After that, we can go again to the design. But first, let's select all of the group members, go to design, design extras, accessories, roof accessories, and you will see our helpers objects. One of them is roof, one of them is wood ceiling. When we select roof surface, we will see a couple of options here. We have all parameters, we have options, geometry options, and also model options. We have different model options here in this menu. By the way, if we change the model here, we will also see the floor plan symbol will be also changed. You can see its preview from this little window. By the way, for this tutorial, I'm gonna go with this Italian tiles and won't change any other parameters. You will see some objects was created onto our roof. They are separate and you can change them settings one by one. And also its model. For instance, let's change this part to metal sheet. Let's click OK and go to 3D window to look at what we have. There we go. We have our metal sheet and our 3D roof parts. They are all 3D, parametric, and with different color combinations to get better render result. If you want to change the color of this, you are going to go to object settings with Ctrl plus T and you will see these surfaces. There are three additional surfaces and it's a good idea to create some new surfaces for those. In order to do this, I'm gonna select the roof surface. There we go, this one. And duplicate it from here. Click the new. And change its name, roof 1, for example. I'm gonna remove texture and duplicate again. This is going to be roof 2. Let's click OK and change the surface color. Another nearest color for this. Duplicate again, roof 3. And this time is going to be dark, maybe. Dark and less saturated. Let's click OK. At this stage, we are going to select all of the roof parts. At the very first, we have to select them one by one. And after that, we can group them. Because you may need to select them in the future with one click. Under the options, we can assign our new surfaces to these surface options. Second one and also third one. By the way, the randomize options here, you can uncheck also. Continue. There we go. I think it's very nice. Our colors are very suitable with each other and I'm very happy with this turned out. But we can increase more. We need some detailed objects for intersected parts of the roofs. Luckily, we have an object for doing this job. Let's go to object. Go to ARCHICAD library. There we go. Click basic library. Open up the menu. Go to this special constructions and accessories. There we have our rich tile. Under the custom settings, you can change its settings, but I won't. I'm going to use this as is. Let's click OK. For doing this job, we are going to place this corner and copy along the whole roof. Let's just place this corner. First corner is going to be at the downside, and the second corner is going to be at the top part. Like so. We are going to change its size, length, in the floor plan. Let's go to floor plan and extend to the top of the roof. Let's go back to 3D and change the elevation of the top part by clicking blue purple, this parametric purple. You can also change the slope here under the settings, but I'm going to do that in the 3D window. Let's change the height here and fix the top part also according to the our roof angle. As you can see, the slope angle can't be changed the bottom side, but we can change the elevation of it from here, and after doing that we can change the other part. Okay, we have done this. Let's go back to the floor plan. And at the floor plan, it was disappeared. How we can get this object appeared? For doing this, at the very first, we have to select the object. Let's select it in the 3D window. And go to settings. And we have this show on stories options. From these parameters, we are going to copy this parameter to project 0. Copy it. And change the home story to 1 and paste. By doing this, we have changed the home story without changing the elevation of object. There we go. Now we can mirror it from the center point of the roof and also to the other corners with the same method. For this operation, you can use your shortcut keys, or instead of that, you can right click the object and click the mirror a copy. In order to find the center point of any edges, you can just hover over it and you will see the center point. For this part, we are going to take help from any elevation in your project. By using elevation of project, you can make this more precisely. After placing this part, we can continue mirroring. And copy to here. And copy to this part. And let's reduce its size and intersect corners and control them in the south elevation, whether they are in correct position or not. By the way, this part is sitting right in place. Truly, when we are constructing this roof, we won't need this part. Therefore, we can delete this. There we go. Now we have two additional pieces to cover our roof ridges. For this purpose, we are going to use same ridges, same ARCHICAD objects. We are going to place this at the top of the roof, and we are going to change this ridge rotation. We can use floor plan. Yes, hit Ctrl plus E and align this top and extend. Maybe more. And also here, extend a little more. before going back to the 3D, we are going to make the slope to 0. We are going to change this inclination parameter. Let's click OK. There we go, we have created our top ridges, but we need some extra fixing operations. For instance, we can change its elevation a little more to cover the bottom parts like this. We can change other inclination for doing this job. And when we are looking this direction, it looks very bad. I have an idea. Let's move this to here. And after that, we are going to select all of the corner ridges. This one. Let's select this. If I can select. Yes. Okay. This corner. This one. And all of them. And we are going to reduce their height from the ground. Once we have done that, we are going to right click, connect and select solid element operation. These are going to be operator, and the main roof is going to be target, and we go with the subtraction with upwards. Let's click execute and look at what we have. There we go. Now we have clean intersections. Let's go back to the floor plan and place remaining top coverings. By the way, I'm removing this sun shading. You can design better, I think. Alright, this is how you can create real 3D roof in ARCHICAD. After this stage, you can continue with creating downspouts and rain locations. The final result will be looked like this. I have a tutorial how you can create downspouts for buildings. You can watch that tutorial, or instead of that, you can watch how I created this downspouts for this building in my Patreon page. You will also see similar tutorials like this, and you can also reach this and also my other tutorials project files. Alright guys, thank you for watching. I see you in the next tutorial.